Okay, just a minute. Okay. So this is where this previous slide is just ended. So this is another picture of a latest quite a bit old, like a few years troop, I think. Before 4 or 5 years, the motherboards was looking like this. Okay, if you want, if you open a desktop, you will find a motherboard like this. At this place, you have to clip your CPU. This is the place for your CPU. And here, these are the ports. It looks like this at the back of your computer. Okay, so these are USB port, LAN port, audio port, and all this PS2. Serial port, VGA port, HDMI is not visible here, but nowadays HDMI is quite popular, right? Then these are the ports for, these are the ports for DDR2 dual channel memory slots or RAM. Okay, then here this SATA headers, that means the SATA hard disks, HDD, are going to be connected to these ports. Okay, this is just a you can't change this, it is the chipset. Okay, so you, when you purchase, and many people will heard that I'm going to purchase an Intel chipset. So what is this chipset? This chipset is here. Okay, then you can see PCI slots are given here. Nowadays we rarely use PCI slots. Okay, then PCI Express slots are also there. Still, I don't use them, but if you are going to install some graphics card, you are going to install sound card, then these slots will be used. Okay. And other parts are there, like I can show this part. These are the ports which are for power supply. Okay, so why I'm showing you, you need to know all these things for forensics part. Okay, we have some forensic part in our syllabus, but if you don't know, then it is very hard for you that how this forensic things works. When somebody sees the computer, some crime happened or something happened in some of his some suicide happened of some of his staff or anything. And then the police is going to basically seize the computer and systems. What those people, the criminal or a victim, whoever, were using. Right. So how they are going to seize it, how you can see whether they are following the correct way of seizing or not, whether they are doing the correct thing to preserve the data properly or not. Because any mistake at the time of seizing the computers, or during the how they are going to store the computer and all, can destroy the data. So it is very important to understand. So logic, this is how physically things are done. Now logically, how things are done. Then we think that, we assume that there is an input output controller. Okay, which is basically have a long bus. Bus means nothing but a connector. Okay, so this input output controller is really there. It is a microchip on the motherboard. Okay, so this controller is having connector embedded in the motherboard, and which connects all the things, all the components of computer together. Okay, it connects with the CPU, it connects the primary memory like RAM, ROM, secondary memory like HDD and DVD tape if there, then flash drives, IO devices like mouse, keyboard, monitor, printer, scanner, and network like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, everything. Everything is connected with the input-output controller. Okay. So now come to CPU. So CPU are the heart or brain of a computer. So we all know it. It is an electronic circuit, fetches the input instruction or commands from the memory unit and performs arithmetic and logical operation. It stores the process data back to memory. So it have three units. You can see the ALU, control unit, and registers. And some examples are like welcome processor. All of your Android phones, most of the Android phones are having Qualcomm Snapdragon processor. I think you all know it. Then our desktops and laptops are using, Intel i7 is one of the example processor they're using, right? Then what is ALU? ALU is arithmetic logical unit. Arithmetic logical unit. So why? Because it does two kind of operation. One is arithmetic operation, another is logical operation. Arithmetic operations like addition and subtraction, depending on the processor, multiplication and division. So usually the basic processor can does only addition. Okay. They does all other operation using addition. Subtraction can be done using addition, binary addition. Okay. There is process, you can go and search it out. Okay. Then multiplication also can be done by addition, you know it, right? So like 2 into 3, it is nothing but adding 2 for 3 times, 2 plus 2 plus 2, right? Then logical operation like AND or NOT, XOR, and bit shift operations like shift the bit with a word either to left or right. Okay. Well, this operation can be done here. Then comes the control unit. Its purpose is to control all the other elements of the CPU, ensuring that they do what they should and when they should, right? So it controls everything. Responsible for controlling the transfer of data and instruction among other units of the computers, which manages the manages and coordinates all the units of the computer and obtain the instruction from the memory, and then interprets them and directs the operation of the computer. Then communication with input-output devices for transfer of data or result from the storage does not process or store data. So control unit does not process data, or it never stores data inside it. Okay. Then registers are the small pieces of memory located inside the CPU. They can be thought of as a hardware version of a variable in software. Hardware version of a variable in software. So if you have written in C code ever, then variable, right? What is variable? So those variables, they